What is going on YouTube? It has been a little while since we've had a sit-down conversation like this. In that period of time, I have turned 30 years old. And in the lead up to turning 30, I, to be completely honest, was kind of anxious. You hear so much stuff nowadays about like life being over at 30. I'm here to set the record straight. You know, I turned 30 in March of this year, so 3 months ago. I feel like I've had enough time to gather my thoughts, to share some important information, the 30 things that I feel like you may be able to benefit from, you know, learning from my mistakes. So without further ado, I'm Alex, you're watching Vagger Brothers, and these are the 30 things that I learned after turning 30. Let's start things off with something very simple. Lesson number one, time flies. Now, that might sound cliche, especially because you've heard it your whole life, but as you start to get older, you really do start to realize just how quickly time flies. We started this channel over 5 years ago, and those 5 years, to be completely honest, have gone by in a heartbeat, in a flash. You really have to remember to be present. You have to remember that the present moment is life. We don't live in the past or in the future. So just remember to be mindful, to be present, because time really does move quickly. Which brings me to my second point, live every day to the max. We live in a hyper plugged in world where we are constantly being bombarded by apps, by photos, by social media. Remember that every single day that you're alive is a blessing. Every single day that you wake up and you are breathing is a little miniature gift, and don't squander it. If there's things that you want to be doing more of in your life, don't put them off. Start finding a way to integrate them into your daily life. And a lot of the times that means waking up earlier. Wake up earlier. I used to be the exact opposite of a morning person. I hated getting up. I loved sleeping in. In the past few years, I've been gradually making that shift, but definitely in the last 6 months, I have really become a morning person. I've made it a goal to wake up at 6 a.m. every morning, to go to the gym and be done with my workout before 9 a.m. Which means that by the time most people are getting in the office, getting ready, I feel like I've already accomplished a lot. Which leads me to step number four. There was a really great speech from the United States Navy Admiral William H. McRaven. He was doing a commencement speech at the University of Texas in Austin. And he shared a very great piece of information. When you wake up in the morning, you have to set intentions for your day. And like it or not, our lives are about completing tasks. That's what work is. So if you start your day by completing a task right off the bat, a simple one like making your bed, you're gonna be one step closer to being organized and efficient and to getting things done. So wake up early and make your bed. I've talked a lot about getting after it, but on the flip side of that, it's really important to remember to be patient. A lot of us are guilty in this day and age of wanting instant gratification, wanting the rewards of hard work without putting in hard work. And I think that it's really important when you're starting out, especially, to be patient and to remember that things that are worthwhile take time. They're not easy. It can apply to any career, any job, any life choice. Reward yourself after you've put in the time and the hard work, and you deserve that reward. Piggybacking on being patient, I want to talk about humility. I think that one of the most important character traits that you can have in this day and age is humility. In the words of Kendrick Lamar, sit down, be humble. He's a very humble person. Even though he's highly successful, he's at the top of his game, he's not flaunting. So be patient and stay humble. We've talked a lot about working hard, but on the flip side of that, it's really important to remember to take care of yourself. My girlfriend, Carrie Rad, has really opened my eyes to the world of self-care, of relaxation. You need to make time to do that. We get messages from all of you amazing Bag of Buddies out there asking for advice on helping to find your calling. Finding your calling might take time, but like I said, you have to be patient with it. You have to put in work and be patient. And when you do that, you will eventually find what it is that fulfills you both personally and professionally, and you will find your path. Now, that being said, finding your path, giving yourself the time to find your path, being patient, being humble. Your 20s are for hustling. Your 20s are for trial and error, for experimentation, for trying to find something that sticks. If you've put a year or two into a project and you're working your ass off and it's still not really catching on for you, you look at it with constructive criticism and say, what am I doing well? What am I not doing as well as I could? And hustle until that gap gets smaller and smaller and smaller until you eventually close the gap and you're at where you want to be. But once you get there, it's not over. It's the same thing over again, but just on a different level. You need to work your ass off because nobody's going to do it for you. And that advice can apply to any career that you're in. If you have a boss, your boss is gonna recognize when you are exceeding expectations, when you're delivering above and beyond, and that hustle is what's gonna take you to the next level of any career that you're in. Say yes more. I am guilty of being pessimistic at times. I'm not telling you to say yes to like, hey, let's go shoot up heroin. Don't do that. Do not do that. Say yes more to allow yourself to step out of your comfort zone, because that's where growth happens. That's where personal growth happens. That's where career growth happens. When you step out of your comfort zone, own your fears, confront them, and move past them, that's where you're gonna grow, and that's where you're gonna have those breakthrough moments. Next up, this one's super important, and it's something that I was guilty of not putting enough of my time or energy into in my 20s. When you're in your 20s, you're in peak physical condition, you don't really need to put too much effort into maintaining that level of fitness. I've had to really make a big effort to be consistent, to make a routine, to eat well, to hit the gym every single day.
It's 5:30 in the morning. I'm about to go for a run.
If you don't really give too much thought about being active or being fit, now is the time to make that change. Let's talk about drugs. Let's talk about substance abuse. I just want to say that drugs are totally overrated. I have had the misfortune of having many friends that I grew up with go off the rails because of substance abuse, because of drug addiction. Some of them have even died from it. And I've seen the pain that that brings to the families of those people, to the friends. Don't do drugs. It's just that simple. This next one is really important, and I'm guilty of it myself. And as much as I like to rely on myself and to think that like I have the power, the willpower to make anything that I want to happen happen if I try hard enough, sometimes, no matter how hard you try, you're not gonna be able to finish this thing, to complete this task alone. And that's when you need to ask for help. Reach out to your friends, reach out to your family. By speaking with someone about them, you allow yourself the opportunity to address and to fix those problems. So if you're in a tight spot, if you aren't feeling 100% mentally, if you are feeling overworked and you can't complete something by yourself, then reach out for help. Friends and family are there for you. Next up, super important. Unfortunately, on YouTube and in the internet, there are many people who are self-proclaimed experts who tell you that you don't need to go to school, that you can make do and drop out and do whatever you want right now. In my opinion, the more time that you can put into your education, the better prepared you're gonna be for life. And that is regardless of whether or not you're enrolled in school. I believe that in life you should never stop learning, ever. Always look at every single day as a new opportunity to get more knowledge, because we live in a knowledge economy. We live in a world where the smarter you are, the more knowledgeable you are, the more employable you are, the better your life is gonna be. So never ever stop that quest for knowledge, whether it's teaching yourself how to learn a new language, brushing up on your mathematics, or teaching yourself a new skill. Never stop learning, because life is a learning curve. And those of you who can excel faster will climb higher. So never stop learning. Don't give up on yourself. If something's hard, ask for help. On the theme of continuing to learn, I want to bring it back into the internal. Learning about yourself. That, in my experience, my 20s, especially like my mid-20s, were all about learning more about myself. I think that when you go through high school, you kind of are like stamped and forced to conform to a certain identity. So I want to encourage you to take the time to find yourself. I did that through having intense solo journeys where I was confronting myself and my thoughts and my beliefs and my internal dialogue. When I graduated college, I went to a music festival in Northern California with some friends, and when they drove home, I rode my bicycle home. Over 1,000 miles camping and riding my bike every single day. Uphills, downhills, back uphills. And when you have those moments, ask yourself, why am I doing this? What is this giving me? That's when you get that deep connection and you find that personal growth and you begin to understand who you are. So reading books like The Alchemist, my favorite book, so simple, simple little novel, but really forces you to confront yourself and ask, who am I? And who do I want to become? Journeys like the Camino de Santiago, which I did in 2012, where I walked for 1 month straight through the countryside of Spain. The Camino is the best way to learn more about yourself. And we all need to learn more about ourselves. Introspection is something that we don't really celebrate in this day and age, and it's so vital to being a well-rounded person. So take the time to learn more about yourself. All right, next one is make new friends, but keep the old. One is silver and the other is gold. It's so true, it's so true. It's as important as it is to make new friends. Never forget where you come from. Never forget the people that you grew up with, your best friends from childhood. Those are the people that are gonna be with you through thick and thin. So remember, as you grow up, as you get older, as you continue to meet new people, it's really important to make new friends. But while you do that, don't do it at the expense of your old friends. On the subject of keeping friends close, keep your family close. I have been blessed to develop a better relationship with my father as I've become an adult. We have a better relationship now because we're kind of like friends versus, you know, father-son relationship. And my relationship with my brother through this entire process of building this channel has improved drastically. I can sympathize with all of you out there. I know that at times it's very difficult to deal with your family, but if you have a relationship that isn't really working out with your family, do what you can to try to mend it. And if you can't mend it, then let it be for now, but don't give up on it. Speaking of which, that brings me to my next point, which is we're mortal. We're human beings. We are born, we live, and then we die. And unfortunately, we have no idea when that's gonna be. So remember that life is fleeting. Life is not guaranteed. You're not guaranteed to wake up tomorrow. So you need to do everything in your power to live the best life that you can now, to be the best version of yourself now, and to continually be learning and improving and trying to become better every single day. Get outside. We live way too much of our lives inside. We are living vicariously through escape via our phones and devices. But remember that life is being lived in the outdoors. We are a part of nature, and for me, I find going into nature extremely restorative. It mellows me out, it recharges me creatively, and it just makes me feel better. That's the easiest way to say it. So I would like to encourage all of you to get outside more. Spend more time in the outdoors. It's an investment in yourself, and you will come home happier and healthier. So get outside. Be nice to people and don't be a dick. Remember that when you interact with a person, those people aren't robots. They're human beings with emotions. And if you can make an effort to be as nice as you can, genuinely, I'm not saying to like suck up and be fake, be real about it, but treat people with respect, be nice, don't be a dick, and it will take you so much further in life. Trust me, when you do good deeds, good things happen to you. Work smarter, not harder. I was guilty of this in my 20s, especially in the early years of Vagabrothers, where there were a ton of tasks, they all had to get done. Marco and I were both working at full capacity. And to make it happen, I would pull all-nighters a lot. And I can tell you that that is not healthy. It's not a long-term solution. So you need to work smarter, not harder. Build a good team around you. Invest in good employees, people who are creative and driven and who will be part of your team for many years to come. Coach them. Give constructive feedback, be nice, and all of those things will help you work smarter and not harder, scale your business, and help get you to where you want to be. Taking care of your body and mind. I think that in this day and age, we're all so caught up in like being on all the time, always being plugged in, always being available, always working. Remember that you are a human and your body and your mind have finite resources. So everything that you can do to recharge yourself is a good investment. Whether that's going and soaking in a hot tub or a hot spring somewhere for an afternoon. Going to a stretch class, a slow, like deep stretch class, like yin yoga. These are the type of activities that are gonna make you feel better and replenished after you do them. And I like to try to treat Sundays as a recharge day. My girlfriend, Carrie Rad, has been so amazing for me because her whole philosophy is like, love yourself and practice well-being and self-care. And one of the benefits of dating her in the last 2 years has been that I've had my eyes opened a lot towards self-care and how to be better at that. And so I have my girlfriend to thank, but I wanna let all of you know out there that it's super important to care about yourself, to care about your mind and your body, and to do whatever you can to keep both of those things functioning at, you know, peak performance. Push your comfort zone. I know you've heard this probably many times in your life, but I'm gonna say it one more time for good measure. There's little things that you can do every single day to push your comfort zone and grow as a human being. Whether that's trying a spicy food, if you don't like spice, saying hello to a stranger or a colleague that you've never talked to before, but you see every day. Do one thing every single day that takes you out of your comfort zone. You will grow immensely from it, and you won't even know that it's happening until you look back 6 months later or a year later and realize how far you've come. With that in mind, I want to talk about self-doubt. It's so important to remember that your self-dialogue, the way that you talk to yourself and the way that you treat yourself, is the most crucial factor into deciding how much you're actually gonna be able to achieve, how successful you're gonna be, how happy you're gonna be. All of this comes back to the most important fundamental building block of your consciousness, which is self-doubt and negative self-talk. If you can eliminate those from your life, if you can remove self-doubt, and if you can silence negative self-talk and replace that with positive encouragement for yourself, then you will succeed. So try your best to be more gentle with yourself, to be more encouraging of yourself, and realize that everything in life is a journey, it's a path. It's not gonna happen overnight. Change takes time. But the most important thing that you can do is commit yourself to making those changes, even if it's just a little bit at a time. Remove the self-doubt, remove the negative talk, and you will be in a much better place much faster than you ever thought possible. You've probably heard the saying, practice makes perfect. I don't like that saying. I don't believe that that's true because I don't think that there is anything in this world that's absolutely perfect. Perfection is a myth. We've created it. Practice doesn't make perfect. Practice makes better. You've probably heard of this concept of 10,000 hours, which basically means that whatever it is that you're trying to do, you need to invest 10,000 hours of practice into that activity until you're gonna reach a level where you will be taken seriously at it. Practice does not make perfect, practice makes better. And when you're better, the more you practice, you become great. So once you've spent 10,000 hours, you've practiced for years at what you want to do. When that opportunity comes, you're prepared. That practice that you've done, the work that you've put in, has gotten you to a place where when an opportunity comes, you can seize it. Seize the moment. Like we've already talked about, life is fleeting, it's short, it's not guaranteed. So when a good opportunity comes your way, catch it, make it yours, make it real. All of that preparation, all of that practice that you've done is for this moment. It's kind of like Eminem in 8 Mile, you know? Lose yourself to the music, the moment you got it, you better never let it go. Hey! Anyways, you know what I'm talking about. Seize the moment, forget the self-doubt, step out of your comfort zone, grab that opportunity and make it yours. Read more. Reading more is something that in my early 20s, after I finished school, I was really hesitant. I didn't want to read anymore because I associated it with like structured education and school and responsibilities and homework. And to be completely honest, it's the exact opposite of that. Reading allows you to escape. It allows you to learn. It allows you to understand yourself better. There's so many benefits that reading more will give you. So I'm not gonna preach about it too much. I think you should read more. Earlier in this video, I talked about delayed gratification, and I really do believe in the value of delayed gratification. But in certain cases, I believe delayed gratification is not the call, especially if there is a really big, meaningful trip that you've been putting off for one reason or another. Now, it could be financial, it could be about time, it could be a relationship that you're in. Whatever it is that's making you not do that one huge trip that you've always dreamed of, you need to start looking and thinking about ways that you can work around those obstacles to make that dream trip happen. Book the ticket, make the commitment, and go from there. Everything else will work out. We're coming towards the end here. I want to wrap things up in a positive way. And my next tip is to practice peace, compassion, and understanding. And in this day and age, in this world that we live in, I feel like we could use a big dose of peace, compassion, and understanding. The world is crazy right now, but we as individuals have the power to make the changes in our personal lives and to take that back out into the world. This is from the Dalai Lama. It was a gift from my aunt. I keep it in my kitchen where I see it every single day. And it says, "The true meaning of life. We are visitors on this planet. We are here for 90 or 100 years at the very most. During that period, we must try to do something good, something useful with our lives. If you contribute to other people's happiness, you will find the true goal, the true meaning of life." Speaking of bringing joy into other people's lives, the last tip that I'll leave here is to open yourself up and open your heart and allow yourself to be loved and to let love in. But if you practice all of these other tips that I've shared here in this video and you open yourself up, then love will find you and everything else will work out. So yeah, those are the 30 things that I've learned in my 30 years here on this planet. I hope that some of these things can help all of you out wherever you're at in your life, wherever you're, you know, feeling those pinch points. Hopefully some of the tips that I've shared here can help get you back on the right track. So thank you for listening. I wanted to say that, you know, by no means am I an expert, but these are some things that, you know, I've learned through experience. And yeah, I really appreciate your time. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe and turn on notifications if you haven't already. And in the meantime, remember, stay curious, keep exploring, and we'll see you on the road. Peace and love.